Es un honor, un privilegio traerles a ustedes a un joven talentoso a quien conocimos hace muchos años.
It is our pleasure to bring before you a young person we've known for many years who is very talented.
Quisiera que unificaran sus manos.
I'd like you to put your hands together
para presentarle
to present
a Herbert Flores.
Herbert Flores.
Thank you. Gracias. I really like the way Ricardo translates, so I'm going to let him translate. I'm going to speak in Spanish and you speak in English, so you do a great job, so.
Me van a dejar el trabajo, gracias a Dios.
Bueno, antes que nada quiero darles a todos la bienvenida y dejarles saber que estoy muy feliz y muy contento de estar compartiendo con todos ustedes.
I'd like to welcome you all and tell you that I'm very pleased to be sharing with each and every one of you this afternoon.
Quiero también dejarles saber pues que ha sido una semana un poquito difícil donde nos han recordado cosas que pasaron hace rato, ¿no?
I'd like to also say it's been a bit of a difficult week, so a lot of things been going on lately, okay?
Quiero también dejarles saber que estoy muy feliz, muy contento de estar de ser parte de esta administración de nuestro ejecutivo del condado, el señor Mangano.
And I am so contented, so pleased to be a part of this winning team of people that are working together with Mangano.
Creo que nuestra Creo que nuestra comunidad latina ha sido muy suertosa, ¿no? de tener el apoyo de un ejecutivo que siempre está preocupado y muy atento de todas nuestras necesidades.
I think the Latin community has been very lucky with having such an executive who is concerned with the needs of our community.
Quiero también en esta ocasión darle las gracias al Chief County Executive, al señor Rob Walker.
We also want to thank Rob Walker, Chief County Executive.
Quiero hablarles un poquito porque, como me decían muchos de ustedes, miembros de la comunidad, que esta administración en realidad la sienten como bien humana y ven los resultados que el Ejecutivo ha tomado hasta ahora y los beneficios que nuestra comunidad ha recibido hasta estos dos primeros meses.
I would like to speak to the point that in which a lot of people in the community have felt that this administration has a very human touch. And we'd like to discuss that a little bit further, I think you were saying.
Definitivamente, vuelvo y lo repito, me siento súper orgulloso de pertenecer a esta administración, así como el señor Rob Walker, también pues un orgullo para que en esta administración esté con nosotros, pues la señora Eldia Gonzalez, también la directora de esta agencia.
And so it is a great pleasure that we are here today with Rob Walker and the director of CASA. Gonzalez here with us today. Thank you, Eldia.
Y antes de continuar, quiero también darle la bienvenida a la señora Mangano.
I would also like to
Linda Mangano.
Say hello to Linda Mangano.
Que es una linda persona y muchos de ustedes pues seguro que ya la conocen, nos apoya muchísimo, así que creo que estamos muy bendecidos.
So many of you know her and so many of us have been blessed by her.
Quiero también darle la bienvenida al señor alcalde y a todas las autoridades del condado de Nassau, al señor alcalde de Freeport y su señora esposa.
The Freeport mayor is here as well. We'd like to thank you for coming and his wife.
Al chairman del partido independiente, el señor Bobby Kumar.
Chairman Bobby Kumar.
Y por supuesto, muchísimos de ustedes que no los quiero mencionar a todos, pero el señor Gil Bernardino, el señor Welkis López, Leo y muchísimos de ustedes, la verdad que estoy muy feliz y muy contento de compartir y que me den esta oportunidad de compartir este lindo día a todos los dominicanos.
There are so many of you who are near and dear to us that it'd be impossible to name you all, but we thank you all for coming and being here with us today.
A la mesa acá que nos acompaña el reverendo Ramírez, el doctor Herrera, la licenciada Elizabeth y por supuesto el pastor acá. Y Marina Londi, que es una súper amiga nuestra desde que estamos pequeños, así es que muchísima alegría, Marina, de compartir.
Round of applause for all the people we have accompanying us on the day this year today.
Bueno, quiero ahora presentarles a la directora ejecutiva de CASA, que quiero hablarles un poquito de ella. Cuando ella entró a la agencia CASA, en realidad acá se estaban viendo de 8 a 10 personas al día.
I would like to speak briefly about the new director here in CASA. I'd like to first mention that the agency was receiving about 8 to 10 people a day coming through the doors.
Desde que la señora Eldia Gonzalez entró a dirigir esta agencia, ahora estamos viendo de 25 a 35 personas al día.
And since Eldia has walked in and taken the reins, we're now seeing 20 to 30 people walking in the door every day.
Nuestro ejecutivo del condado ha sido muy específico con eso, que tenemos que servir a nuestra comunidad y estamos muy contentos con esos nuevos reportes que estamos llevando a cabo.
And the county executive having given a mandate that he would like us to serve for a larger degree the Latin community, this information is very wonderful news.
Y sin nada más que decir, quisiera presentarles al director ejecutivo, la señora Eldia González.
And without any further ado, we present the executive director of CASA, Eldia González.
P. Mangano. Welcome County Chief Deputy Rob Walker. Welcome Pastor Basilio, Reverend Alan Ramirez, Dr. Herreras, Attorney Elizabeth Irena, and Marina Lundi. First Lady, Ms. Linda Mangano, it's our pleasure to have you with us this afternoon. Welcome. Welcome Mayor of Freeport, Mayor Andrew Hardwick and his lovely wife. Welcome Chairman Bobby Clory. Welcome members of the Latino Press and to all our guests. Today here at CASA, we are celebrating the 166 years of the independence of the Dominican Republic. I am very proud to be a Dominican nationality. This is an occasion to honor the rich history and culture of the country. It was in 1844 that the Dominican Republic won its independence from Haiti. CASA, which stands for Coordinating Agency for Spanish American, is the only government agency that provides many services to the Latino community, such as housing assistance, provide bilingual support assistance to clients seeking information about existing community agencies, assist clients with immigration and naturalization services, free English ESL classes, GED in Spanish, and computer skills. This is to give an example of some of the services that CASA provides. With my administration at CASA, as you can notice, there has been some changes. The appearance, for example, of the agency. And one of the major changes is that as per my instructions, the appointment system to see the clients have been removed. And this has created that the clients seen in CASA has tripled the amount. It is my honor. It is my honor to serve the Latino community. And I personally thank Executive Mangano for giving me this opportunity. I also want to take this opportunity to thank my friend Herbert Flores and my staff, Beatriz Lozada, Miriam Alfaro, and Grace Gomez for such a great help. And as our county executive always says, together, we will make Nassau County a better place to live, work, and raise our families. I thank you all for coming. Enjoy the rest of the day.
Bueno, esos aplausos. Yo quiero escucharlos más. Que nazcan desde lo más recóndito de sus corazones, de una persona, una dominicana, de puro corazón, que ha trabajado muy fuerte para lograr donde ella está en este instante.
I would love to hear another round of applause for a Dominican woman who has worked very hard to get where she has gotten, and she deserves another round of applause. From the bottom of our hearts, thank you, Eldia.
El año pasado, Tuve el honor y el privilegio de hacer unas presentaciones en diferentes lugares, pero recuerdo que en el Suffolk Community College tuvimos el honor de rendir honor a quien honor merece.
I've had the pleasure over the years to honor and speak before many, many people, and last year one stands out to me in particular.
Hay dos personas en este lugar que fueron recibidos, receptores de unas placas oficiales para celebrar el mes de la herencia dominicana.
There are two people present who received plaques to commemorate the month of the Dominican Republic.
Uno de ellos es el Dr. Herrera, para quien pido un gran aplauso.
Dr. Herrera, who I honor today.
Y ahora el honor y el privilegio de presentarles a ustedes quien en esta tarde le hablará palabras referente a República Dominicana, la licenciada Elizabeth. Venga los aplausos para Elizabeth.
And have the honor and privilege of presenting attorney Elizabeth Arena. Yes.
Ella dirá dos palabritas que tiene para ustedes.
And she will speak a few words today. That's all she wrote. One second there. Herb, the AV guy over here, doing a great job. All right.
Good afternoon.
Buenas tardes.
County Executive Mangano.
Ejecutivo Mangano.
Eldia. Mayor Hardwick.
Alcalde Hardwick.
Friends, family.
Amigos, familia.
And fellow invitees.
Y invitados.
Lifelong resident of Nassau County.
Como un residente de por toda vida aquí en el condado de Nassau.
And a Dominican American.
Y una dominicana americana.
I am honored to receive this recognition.
Tengo la honra de recibir este reconocimiento.
From the county I have called home.
Del condado que yo he llamado casa.
All of my life.
Toda mi vida.
I was born in Rockville Center.
Me nací en Rockville Center.
I was raised in Freeport.
Criado en Freeport. Me too, by the way. Hometown, Freeport's the hometown.
I actually attended high school here in Hempstead at Sacred Heart Academy.
Actualmente atendí escuela secundaria aquí en Sagrado Corazón, aquí en Hempstead.
I briefly left the county.
Brevemente me fui del condado.
And I went to the university.
Y me fui a estudiar a la universidad.
I went to Fordham University.
La Universidad Fordham. Donde recibí más tarde me gradué con mi licenciatura en leyes, derecho.
What I find most interesting about this honor that I'm receiving today.
Lo que encuentro más interesante de haber recibido esta honra en el día de hoy.
Is that when I started the path towards my education.
Que cuando comencé el trayectorio de mi educación.
I really wanted to work in politics.
Verdaderamente quería trabajar en la política.
I really dedicated myself to learning about government.
Me dediqué a aprendizaje del gobierno.
And I really had the opportunity to work with Hispanics and people of the entire world.
Y tuve la oportunidad, el privilegio de trabajar con latinos por todo el mundo.
My first job out of college.
Mi primer trabajo de la universidad después de haber graduada.
Was at the United Nations.
Fue en las Naciones Unidas.
And my job there was to help women.
Y me dediqué allá a trabajar con mujeres.
That needed to learn how to use their environment.
Mujeres que necesitaban aprender a usar su atmósfera, ¿verdad?
To actually accomplish such simple tasks as boiling hot water and carrying it.
Para hacer tan simples talleres como hervir agua y cargarla.
Chopping wood appropriately so that they wouldn't hurt their backs.
Cortar leña de tal manera que no lastima la espalda o no cansa.
And that in more advanced countries, helping women balance work and a family.
Y en países más desarrollados, ayudando mujeres balancear el trabajo y la familia.
But as quickly as I was able to reach my dream.
Pero de igual manera que tuve la oportunidad de alcanzar mi sueño.
It was quickly eliminated due to a budget restructure.
Este, rápidamente fue eliminada mi posición a deber por deber por este los presupuestos cortaron y eliminaron la posición.
So I came home to Freeport.
Entonces me vi en el evento de tener que regresar a Freeport.
And I had a long conversation with my father.
Tuve una conversación larga con papá.
And I said, Dad, what next?
Y le dije, papi, ¿qué ahora?
And he told me, go back to school, get a law degree.
Y me dijo, regresa a la escuela y acaba tu estudio de leyes. Y eso fue lo que hice. Durante los años he tenido la oportunidad y el privilegio de haber trabajado con muchas organizaciones.
First in the private sector,
en el sector privado primario.
And then within the legal community.
Y también dentro de la comunidad legal.
But throughout all the environments that I've found myself in,
pero por todos los lugares que me he encontrado.
I always go back to my two main loves.
Siempre regreso a mis dos amores.
And that is education.
Educación.
And legalization.
Y legalización.
I had the benefit of being born in the United States.
Yo tuve el privilegio de haber sido nacida en los Estados Unidos.
So I don't know what it's like to not have a green card.
No sé, en verdad, lo que es pasar la situación de no tener un estatus legal de migratorio. No sé lo que es cruzar la frontera mexicana.
But I do know that once you get to this side,
pero sí sé que cuando llegas a este lado,
there's opportunity for people to rise above their situation.
Hay oportunidad para gente sobrellevar su estatus ahora mismo. Y como muchos de ustedes me conocen personalmente, ¿verdad?
You know that my two loves are education.
Ustedes saben que mis dos amores son educación
and, for folks to become legalized.
Y para ayudar a la gente a legalizarse.
Because once we achieve education and legalization,
porque una vez alcanzamos las metas de legalización y educación,
really there is nothing stopping us.
No hay nada que nos pueda aguantar. Quiero agradecerle a todos y a cualquiera que ha tenido, aunque sea un granito de arena en la vida mía, de mi educación y en mi crianza.
But I especially want to thank my parents,
pero en particular a mis padres
and my husband,
y a mi esposo.
For their support.
Por su apoyo.
Mr. Mangano.
Ejecutivo Mangano.
Eldia. And the staff at casa.
Y los trabajadores de casa.
Thank you for hosting this event.
Gracias por tener este evento.
And for being such an important voice for the Hispanic community.
Y por ser una voz tan importante en nuestra comunidad latina.
And especially because you're in Nassau County.
Y en particular porque son aquí en el condado de Nassau.
And I'm really excited that Mr. Mangano is the executive.
Estoy muy entusiasmada de ver el nuevo ejecutivo Mangano.
When I was preparing for this today, I told my father.
Cuando me preparaba para hablar hoy día, le dije a mi padre.
I still remember the days when Ed Tom Galata, was the executive of Nassau.
Aún me recuerdo los días cuando Galata era el ejecutivo del condado.
And those were some of the best years of my life.
Y eso eran algunos de los mejores años de mi vida.
Prosperity and peace that we had during those times.
Y espero que la prosperidad y paz que tuvimos en esos años
continue during your time.
Continúen durante tus años aquí.
Thank you very much.
Muchas gracias. And now, y ahora, we will have a few words. Tendremos unas palabras spoken. To us by Teddy Acevedo, your master of ceremonies. Nuestro maestro de ceremonia, Teddy Acevedo, nos va a dar unos versos ahora en este momento. Así que un aplauso para Teddy Acevedo.
Muchísimas gracias una vez más.
Thank you again.
Voy a recitar un verso que es muy dominicano.
I would like to speak of a verse that is very Dominican.
Esta es la historia de un padre.
This is the story of a father
que no tenía dinero,
that had no money,
pero tenía el deseo,
but had desire,
de que su hijo,
that his child,
tuviera la siguiera la misma pauta,
would have the same dreams.
Okay.
I'm trying.
Entonces el padre no tenía dinero.
His father had no money.
Y antes de morir,
and before dying,
él quería regalarle,
he wanted to give his son,
el fruto de su experiencia.
The fruit of his experience.
¿Cómo comienza?
How does that begin?
Comienza así.
It begins this way.
Bueno, mi hijo.
Well, son.
Según la ley, ya somos casi iguales.
According to the law, we're almost the same, you and I.
¿Ya te entregó el documento que te acredita como hombre?
You are now receiving the documents that declare you as a man.
De hoy en más, lo que hagas, lo que pienses y lo que sientas,
from now on, what you do, what you think, and what you say,
tendrá que sustentarlo con tu plata, tu brazo y tu conciencia.
You will have to sustain with your own money, your own strength, and your own vigor.
Todita es la lucha con que la vida de la lucha entra. Y usted sabe bien el empeño que hemos puesto para que llegara mozo la tuviera.
In life there is struggle, and you know well the struggle that we've had to give you life.
Mientras nos vamos acercando a casa,
while we approach home,
¿dónde estará su mamá como crezca?
Where is your mother?
Loca de contenta de abrazar el hombre con que el cielo al final la recompensa.
What man desires most in life.
Le voy a decir las últimas palabras que le guardó para esta hora mi experiencia.
I will tell you the last words that I've received until this day.
Si le estorban, las oyes y las olvidas.
I missed that. This is very hard.
Si,
translating words is one thing. Translating poetry.
Okay. We got the part.
You know what? I'm going to step down. Go ahead. You do your thing. Go ahead, Teddy. Round of applause for Teddy. Come on, Teddy.
Si le estorban, las oye y las escucha. Entonces, mi hijo, si le sirve, las oye y las recuerda para que en esta forma te ayuden a encauchar el mundo en este largo viaje que te espera. Ser guapo, mi hijo, no es creerse más varón que cualquiera, ni andar en barra, en una dejando fama de borracho y en otra de mancharrón de rajena. La de la cantina son pa' por si acaso. La calle en la ventana pa' querencia son la que pone Dios en su custodia para resguardarle el nombre en la custodia de ella. Cuando le toque votar, cuando le toque hacer un servicio que llegue su mano antes que su ofensa, las palabras y la firma no se niegan, así le cueste soportar la vida en lo más desgraciado de la pobreza. Ser honrado, mi hijo, es el mérito más grande como no serlo la mayor vergüenza. Y escuche bien esta sentencia que fue las condiciones de su abuelo. Aquel que no sabe ofender, no admite ni acepta ofensa. Nadie muere un día antes según la ley de Dios. Ni tampoco hay sangre de gallina en vuestra vena. Para defender la vida es el cuchillo. Para castigar agravio la soltera. Y si un día un extraño de tu tierra le perdiese respeto a esa bandera, ahí sí de entero varón. Nunca más hombre, nunca más firme el brazo y tu conciencia. Dominicano, dominicano a las malas, a la buena, caiga el que caiga. Así le cuesten llamar a su padre para levantar el mismo osamenta. Que el que mata o perece por su patria, ha cumplido con las leyes de su tierra.
Teddy, thank you so much for that. I think Teddy missed his calling. He was a thespian in another life, right? This man is an actor, a poet, everything. Round of applause for Teddy Acevedo. Thank you for that poem, Teddy. And now, Teddy, please resume your duty as MC, and let's carry on with the afternoon.
Muchísimas gracias. Ese verso lo vamos a celebrar mañana en vivo con una presentación muy exclusiva.
That poem we will be doing at live tomorrow afternoon.
At the Suffolk Community College.
The Suffolk Community College.
In Brentwood at 3 o'clock p.m.
En Brentwood a las 3 de la tarde.
So you are cordially invited from 3 to 7.
Son cordialmente invitados de 3 a las 7 de la noche.
Celebrating this 166th anniversary of the Dominican Republic independence.
Celebrando una vez más el aniversario de la independencia de la República Dominicana.
So I would like all of you.
Me gustaría verlos todos.
To join me and my committee.
Allí con nosotros y mi comité.
In this very lovely special celebration.
En esta celebración especial.
Thank you once again. 3 o'clock p.m. tomorrow, Suffolk Community College.
Gracias de nuevo. 3 de la tarde mañana, Suffolk Community College.
Ha sido predestinada, elegida por ese pueblo que tenía tantas necesidades, tantas cosas de esperar un cambio. Señoras y señores, con el aplauso de ustedes, recibamos a nuestro ejecutivo.
We'd like to receive at this time our county executive, Ed Mangano.
Telling figure is that she is seeing 3 times the people in need than the prior administration. She's a tireless worker. And that's what this administration is about, creating opportunities. They work so hard. I want to acknowledge Herb Flores. Herb's been a wonderful asset to our administration. He's another tireless worker. And what I like to say, in our administration, first, it's open to all. We want to work together to make Nassau County a better place for all of us. That is our purpose, regardless of party, regardless of race, religion. Those that want to work together, this administration is open to work together. We have here today Mayor Andy Hardwick. Now, the mayor, obviously, on the other side of the aisle. But we have been working together since the day after my election. He's extended a hand to work together. And it's important that we do. And it's important that everyone in this room come together. You're all community leaders, Ray Lopez, Leo Fernandez, Bobby Kumar. Look, you know, during election time, people have different views, and they have different agendas, and they have different beliefs, and that's fine. You know, that is our democracy. But the election has ended. And you know, I had committed that once we were successful, and we did believe we would be successful from day one, we would work with all. So we welcome all. Just because you didn't perhaps support my candidacy, or perhaps you had disagreements with those that worked on my campaign, the time now is to come together. We don't hold any grudges. Those that are living in the past, and I do believe that is what is occurring in a very small degree, but one that gets a lot of press, you know, there's some media that gives it, you know, too much attention. It's not right. And is that what we're about? Is that how we want to be defined? It's wrong. It's wrong. It's not why I wanted to become county executive. I didn't want to become county executive to punish those that didn't share my political views? No. I didn't like the direction of Nassau County. This is a very different speech, and maybe not one that you expected today, but I think in this room it's important because I see many people from different sides, some that supported, some that didn't. And I know, I don't think Bobby will mind if I point to Bobby. Bobby Kumar, chairman of the Independence Party, somebody that I know a very, very long time, somebody that I respect. And, you know, he did not support me during the campaign. he had his reasons, and that is fine and understood. But the day after, we came together, and we're working together on the issues that will make our county a better place. So, I simply ask you, all of you, anyone that wants to work with this administration, it is open to work with you. But I will tell you this, those that want to make it political for their own self-interests, and that's what you have to look at. What purpose those that tear down others serve to our great county? Is it the broader purpose in this county? I ask you, is it? It is not. It is not. It is their own self-interest. We have elections. There are winners. There are losers. The day after, you go to work for the people. These people here want to work for the people. Herb Flores wants to work for the people. He deserves it. Right. Absolutely. And it warms my heart that you give him that welcome. It really does. And I just want to speak from the heart today. Anyone's head and heart that's united in the same purpose to do good things, we can do it. We're going to change the shameful waste of money in this county. I don't care who you want to blame it on. It's there. I'm not even blaming it. You don't see me running around blaming. I'm running around with good people saying we want to fix it. That's this administration. Let's fix it. This real property assessment issue. And you say, well, why would that come up on in a forum like this with beautiful honorees? Because we have a forum here where we could talk about something that hurts every single one of us in this room. Aside for a very few that perhaps, you know, profit from this shameful waste of dollars, it hurts us. It wastes your money. All I want to do is fix it. And then you can fight over the money. But we're wasting the money. We're wasting the money. We're not delivering services. So I'm going to tell you this, and then I'm going to go back to congratulate the honorees. But this is how big the problem is. 46% of all the debt in Nassau County, almost one half of the debt, all went to errors. Almost over $1 billion. You know what the other $1 billion in Nassau County's debt did? It built buildings. It improved our parks. It paved our roads. It created jobs. It made lasting improvements for not only us, but future generations. That's where that half of the money went. The other half came out of your pockets and went nowhere. It's a shameful waste of money, and I use that word. We have to come together. I am positive and confident if we come together, we can stop wasting the dollars. We may not be able to correct all the errors. We can save those dollars, and those are very important. And we'll come together and help all of us. So I ask you all, come along, help us out, be part of this administration, and if you can, on the side, the people that should be condemned are those that are condemning others for their own personal purpose. I don't like it. It's wrong. And I can't say that enough. There's so many good people in here. There's so much good energy in here. Let's come together. Let's use it wisely, as these honorees have done in their lives. Right? I mean, they've done such good things. You're all deserving honorees. We could stand here next year and celebrate that we have stopped wasting money and that we are rewarding people, rewarding great efforts, and pulling people up the ladder of success instead of tearing them down. So those are the words I want to leave you with. Come together, those united in head and heart, I'd like to say. And as I went through my election cycle, there was so much good spirit that was provided to me, so much positive energy that is so dear to me, that is my commitment to use that and to respect that by doing the right thing in government. And that's what we will strive to do, despite what some media wants to print. And I want to commend all the media that's reporting what's going on here, the great achievements of Eldia Gonzalez. You will hear about great achievements from her, Flores. You will hear about great achievements from everyone in our administration. You will hear of great collaborations between the mayor and myself, between Nassau County and the village of Freeport, because we are all one. You will hear of great collaborations between all the people of Nassau County. Come together, join us for a great journey.
Y ahora,
and now,
tenemos el honor de presentar al ballet. ¿Dónde están los jóvenes del ballet que pueden pasar por aquí?
And now we have a special group of guests who are here. Some ballet, some dancers are here with us today.
Ya casi nos estamos preparando. Ahí están. Let's give a round of applause.
I'd like to thank Fundación Onyx for bringing these lovely girls with us today and providing us with this wonderful rendition. And we thank you very much for coming.
Señoras y señores, del ballet folclore dominicano, su música en esta tarde que es representada con el ballet folclórico de Queens. ¡Venga los aplausos!
Thank you.
Queremos darle las gracias a la Fundación ONI por la presentación del ballet de Queens. ¡Un aplauso!
Thank you, ladies, and from all the way from Queens. Thank you so much.
Señoras y señores, en esta oportunidad me parece.